Hello friends, welcome to AKS. Today we are dealing with a very important topic called International Space Station. See, it is important for two reasons. First is, we want to build our own space station in the coming future. The second one is, an all-woman crew has done some repair of the International Space Station by doing a spacewalk. So what is spacewalk, we will deal in a separate video. We'll discuss International Space Station now. So when we are dealing with International Space Station, we will look into what is the purpose of International Space Station. What kind of scientific research goes on here? And how do we explore? Next is, what is the structure of International Space Station? What are the systems which are present here? And what kind of repairs go on and how do they do repairs? And is there any radiation effect to it? And when will be the end of the mission? And what are the other prospects of this mission and coming future prospects? So let us look at the 2019 mains question. What is India's plan to have its own space station and how will it benefit our space program? See, as we have discussed, science and technology has become a dynamic field and the questions are not only about the current, they are about the future prospects of science and technology. So as we have discussed in the earlier session, 2019 Chandrayaan 2 was heading towards moon and the question was on 2017. So UPSC is far ahead. So we need to streamline accordingly our preparation. So let us start. So what is International Space Station? See, this is a habitable artificial satellite in low Earth orbit. See, it is a satellite, but it is habitable and it is in low Earth orbit. See, when we are discussing orbits, we'll discuss about low Earth orbit, medium Earth orbit, high Earth orbit, etc. But just remember that low Earth orbit is very close to our Earth and it is 400 plus kilometers. And it is easy to launch a satellite over here. So it is a joint project of five big organizations: NASA, Roscosmos, that is of Russia, JAXA of Japan, Canada Space Agency, and European Space Agency, and the NASA. So this is a joint project of all these five space research organizations. The ownership and the use of space station is established by intergovernmental treaties and agreements. That is, all intergovernment treaties are signed and they do this activity accordingly. The International Space Station serves as a microgravity experimental station and the space environment research in which crew members conduct experiments on human biology, meteorology, etc. And this International Space Station is suited for testing spacecraft systems and equipment required for missions to Moon and Mars. International Space Station maintains an orbit with average altitude of 400 kilometers by means of reboost maneuvers using engines. See, the station is divided into two. First is Russian orbital segment, which is by Russia, and US orbital system, which are shared by nations. Here there is an astonishing fact that first ISS component was launched in 1988 and till now, that is approximately 18 years and 350 days, still it is working. And this is a continuous longest human presence in low Earth orbit. That That is to say that from the past 18 years and 350 days, some or the other human being is in that space station. It is never vacant and it is still working. So it is very important because it is the longest continuous human presence in the low Earth orbit. So what does International Space Station contain? The components. First is pressurized habitation modules, structural trusses, solar arrays, radiators, docking ports, experimental base and robotic arms. These are some of the components of International Space Station. So now let us see what is the purpose of International Space Station. Originally it was a observatory, laboratory, factory while providing transportation, maintenance and low Earth orbit for staging base for possible future missions to Moon, Mars and asteroids. That is to say that it was working as an observatory, laboratory and factory for providing transportation and maintenance of low Earth orbit. With this space station, we used to look into Moon and Mars prospects, and the ISS provides a platform to conduct scientific research with power, data cooling and crew available to support experiments. The International Space Station simplifies experiments by allowing group of scientists to share same launches and crew time. See, let us understand the complexity of International Space Station. See, they are approximately 400 plus kilometers above the Earth's atmosphere where there is no oxygen or any other gases. If it is to say that it is almost extremely difficult workspace to work, because see, there is no oxygen, there is no gravity or very less gravity, there is a free fall, and every component of the ISS should be accurate. A small mistake can cost our lives. Let us understand with a crude example. You have took a flat in an apartment. We have to bring in a lot of infrastructure and make it a habitable environment. But when you are going into International Space Station, just imagine the complexity of what kind of instruments it requires, what kind of transportation it does, the parameters which need to be taken care of, like radiation, gravity, work environment, mental pressure, and lot of complexities are involved in such kind of heavy projects. So International Space Station is not only difficult to work, but there are different permutations and combinations when you have to work there. So now what kind of research goes on in International Space Station? First is astrobiology, astronomy, physical sciences, material sciences, space weather, meteorology and human research. So the space environment is hostile to life. Unprotected presence in space is characterized by intense radiation field. See, you are in a no man's land and you can be subjected to any kind of environment, like you can have solar flares, intense radiation, some space debris can hit the space station, lot of issues involved, and simple forms of life exist there, like extremophiles and small invertebrates called tardigrades survive here. Only these are present there. Apart from that, there is no other organisms which can live in that uninhabitable environment. So, free fall. Gravity at altitude of ISS is approximately 90% as strong as Earth's surface. But objects are in continuous state of free fall. That is, you do not lie stable at one place. You are subjected to free fall. So this is the example of free fall. This is International Space Station. You are always subjected to floating in that place, and it is very difficult for here to survive. The scientists here are subjected to different kinds of environment, The exploration. International Space Station provides a location in relative safety of low Earth orbit to test spacecraft system that will be required for long duration mission to Moon and Mars. See, low Earth orbit is present. It is easy to go to 400 kilometers rather than mid MEO or HEO. This is comparatively safer and easy to approach. And this provides experience in operation, maintenance, as well as repair and replacement activities on orbit. If you look into the structure of it, it is a third generation modular space station. It can allow modules to be added or removed from existing structure, allow greater flexibility. If you see the International Space Station, if there is any issues in some of the parts, it can be removed and again replaced. So in this process, it is staying in the space from 18 years and 350 days, approximately 19 years you could say. The kind of systems involved in this. First is life support system. Critical systems are atmosphere control systems, water supply, food supply, sanitation and hygiene equipment, fire detection and suppression equipment. See, as we have discussed, a lot of equipment is required because you are in an artificial environment wherein you have to create everything from atmosphere control. You have no oxygen or very low oxygen, so oxygen is required, and water supply, food supply and sanitation and hygiene need to be taken care of, and the pressure is also high, so we will have to look into the suppression equipment also. So apart from all the challenges, radiation is another concern. See, ISS is partially protected from space environment by Earth's magnetic field. From distance of about 70,000 kilometers, depending on the solar activity, the magnetosphere begin to deflect solar wind around the Earth and ISS. So solar flares are still hazard to crew of the International Space Station. So radiation is one of the prime concern over there. So the end of the mission. According to the Outer Space Treaty, US and Russia are legally responsible for all modules they have launched. Okay, so now International Space Station will be wearing out in a few years, and now the alternatives are coming in terms of China and India. All have an intention to build their own space stations. And see, India is trying to become a superpower, so it is always better to have our space station so that our research can be more fruitful. And moreover, having an International Space Station, we will become one of the space elites. We are already into the space elite club in different areas like ASAT, cryogenic engine, becoming the first to go to Mangalyaan, etc. So we will hope that our International Space Station becomes a lightning conductor for the space research. On this note, thank you very much. If you have any suggestions, feedbacks or comments, the comment box is open for you. Thanks again.